question related to specific projects, or?
Question just said, where do you see the program continue?
Okay, generally, I see the program continue to develop. Obviously, and I appreciate the opportunity to say South Haven, Mississippi is more than just baseball. We do things that make economic sense. The baseball operation at Snowden set the model throughout the state. It's unheard of, the progress that we've had there. But we'll continue moving on. We want to do the same thing with soccer. We've got tennis coming now. We want to do some things with girls volleyball, also indoor Greenbrook training facility. So we want to continue expanding on it and continue to be the leader in parks and recreation, not just in the state of Mississippi, but throughout the region.
Thank you. Mr. Leifenbach?
Well, I'm going to ask a fair question. I mean, because it changes year to year, every 5 years, every leadership, every administration, it changes. I mean, there's no way to project 10 years down the road. But what we'd like it to be is be even more be more cleaner, have more trash pickup dollars, have police duct station at every park with a sky cop cam, where if citizens see suspicious activity, call police department, they can look on the cam, revolve that camera 360 degrees around and see what's going on, and see if police cars need to be out there patrolling more, instead of him going out there, three or four of them going out there to a park and just sitting there babysitting the park. You know, that's just when they should be in the community fighting crime. So, you know, there's things we can do to improve the park, but we're heading down the right direction. I don't think there should be any change other than getting the funding.
Mr. Henry?
It is correct. South Haven has a state-of-the-art baseball facility. As far as the other parks, in 10 years, I'd love to see, you know, a sensory park, a spray park. I'd like to see bike trails to where people that don't play baseball have things to do also in the city. I'd like to see parks that are well-maintained and free of, you know, graffiti. I'd like to see, you know, also I'd like to see cameras in our parks and within the next 10 years. Because I think a park situation is great for our whole community.
Next question will be to each of the individuals up here. And then this time I'm going to start with Mr. Geis. What is your view on the heroin epidemic in our county? And what is your plan of action to save our young people, since DeSoto County is number one in overdoses in our state?
The heroin epidemic in DeSoto County is just like everywhere else. It's getting bad, getting worse every day. My plan on that would be to fully staff the police department, have them properly trained. Currently, we're 8 officers short, so it's hard to be out there stopping that type of crime.
for us to have facial recognition software and tag reading capabilities. I also believe that our judicial system needs to handle the dealers and, you know, to the highest extent of the law possible. And then I believe the end user, we need to show some grace and try to work with them to get them clean. But as the others have mentioned, it's going to start in our schools, it's going to start at home, and it's going to start in our communities before we can really get a handle on it.
Thank you. Mayor Musselwhite?
Well, it's important to note that the statistics about DeSoto County can be a little bit misleading. DeSoto County has a great population in the state of Mississippi, so that's why our numbers are higher. The heroin problem is a problem everywhere. It's not just in DeSoto County, it's everywhere in our country. You can't rely on, I will disagree with Mr. Henley, all of our problems do not come from Memphis. You know, heroin is a problem that affects every city. It comes in South Haven, we fight it from all of our borders, not just the northern border. I don't know how much cameras really help with that. Our police do a fantastic job. They do have to be very proactive, as they are, in fighting drug dealers. But the biggest issue, or the biggest thing I would note tonight, is that government can't solve every problem. This problem starts at home, it starts in the schools, and I would just encourage parents, you know, to be the parent first and not your child's friend, and don't be afraid to say no. I mean, pay attention to who they're hanging out with, because this does not start at 17, 18. This problem starts at 12, 13, younger, and a lot of times we as parents don't pay attention, but pay attention to who your kids are hanging out with, because the problem can best be solved at home.
When we convict someone and then once they're released, the problem is we release them right back in the same environment we took them out of. Until we change the environment, you're always going to have that revolving door. And I learned this from the Texas Sheriff when I was growing up. If you don't change the environment, you just have a revolving door. Because if we're going to take people and put them in treatment and spend all, I don't think people really understand how much it costs. It could be like $75,000 per person to put them through treatment. And to think, put them back in that same environment we took them out of, just so they can end up spending another $75,000 in treatment. We need to change the environment. One of the things we can do is take the executive authority and tear down these drug houses as they come along. If they're declared a drug house, tear them down because they're damaging for the community and in property value, and they're damaging for future generations. It's just an epidemic within itself.
Thank you. Now we pose a question to Hernandez.
Mayor Johnson.
As a county seat and home to many judicial proceedings, do you think it's possible to balance both growth and maintain the history of Hernando?
It absolutely is possible, and I think we've been showing that. The population's grown about 50% since I've been mayor, and we are proud to be the county seat, and I think there's some responsibility that comes with that. I think anybody that looks at Hernando or thinks about Hernando or lives in Hernando, when they think about home, they're picturing the historic area, and we have to protect that at all costs, and we have done that. We actually have got a grant we're working on right now to make our downtown more pedestrian friendly, and that grant had to go before the state Department of Archives and History to make sure that we did it in a way that did not adversely affect the historical aspects of downtown. And as we redo our comprehensive plan, once we see the new board, it's halfway through the season on our comprehensive, our 30-year plan, so it's time to update it. But we're going to have to make sure that we get an overlay district for the historic area, which we don't have now, because the rules that work on the Walmart side of town don't necessarily work on the historic side of town. Some things that just would make common sense on the historic side don't fit our current laws. So we need to change those laws and design guidelines to make that work, because I think everybody wants to protect those historic buildings, and I think we're doing a pretty good job of doing that.
Next steps can be made to attract higher-end housing developments in Horn Lake?
The first thing that I would suggest is improving our infrastructure. When someone drives into a town looking to purchase a home, purchase land, or even start a business, that's the first thing they're going to notice, how well-maintained the streets are, the sidewalks are, how the houses look, is the grass cut along the public areas, and that would be one of the first things I would do. The other thing, you need to change the comprehensive plan for the city, set it up where you can only build larger homes, because to be honest, the city of Horn Lake has plenty of smaller homes and starter homes. That's not a problem that started under Mayor Latimer. That has been a problem for a long time. And those mistakes were made, and whoever the current mayor will be after this election is going to have to deal with that. And that would be one of the things that I would do.
Mayor Latimer?
I appreciate the kind words, Mr. Mike. Thank you. As Mr. Dice noted, we started out abundance of small starter homes, which was the style back in the 1960s and 1970s. As times have changed, families' income gets a little bigger, they move out to a bigger house, and those properties end up, to a large number, being rental homes. We have a lot of people who live in smaller homes that maintain their homes and their property in a most excellent way. Our code enforcement has been going through and really cracking down on the citizens who do not maintain their residences. Our citizens who own homes are the ones demanding stricter code enforcement. This last board meeting, I believe the Board of Aldermen voted to go in and clean up 49 more properties. We are attracting more homes and larger homes down in Cold Place, off of Scott Street, which the street needs some work. We're having a lot more interest in people coming in and building larger homes. I think many of you out there, the audience, probably have a perception of Horn Lake as strictly small homes, but I ask you to go to the Cold Place.
Last question before we have the closing statements goes to the city of South Haven. We begin with Mr. Leifenbach. What is your educational background as well as work professional experience that you feel enables you to lead as mayor?
Well, I went to high school, no college, but basically in life experience, that my education, and that's basically but I've mostly been in, you know, been in Jack's Ball Trade, mostly been in the heavy business, and closer to the housing building. But I've always been, when I grew up in the military, I've always been, you know, that leadership type mind to lead the truth. And I always thought of myself as a leader. That's how I've never been comfortable with the legislature. I don't like sharing leadership, so to speak. I like to be the one that with the whip saying, hey, no, you can't do this. Let's move it over to this one. I mean, just from being in business, you have to learn how to take care of yourself and learn how to lead. They pretty much teach you that in school, and they teach you that in the community. They teach you that in the church, your community centers,
Fortune 500 companies for the last 30 years. I've dealt with anywhere. number machines, to negotiating contracts, to establishing safety protocols to keep, you know, to keep people safe. I've learned excellent negotiating skills on the contractual side of my business, which I think South Haven could definitely use. Other than, you know, my business experience and life experience, I would say that's it.
Thank you, Mayor Musselwhite.
Well, as far as education, I'm a 1985 honor graduate from South Haven High School, very proud of my Chargers. I received a Bachelor of Business Administration from Ole Miss with a degree in managerial finance in 1989. One of the best things about my career is my sports career. That's been one of the biggest blessings to my life as far as how that prepared me to be mayor. My sports career taught me integrity, work ethic, and mental and physical toughness. And I will tell any of these guys standing up here tonight, if you don't have some of that, you're applying for the wrong job. My business skills, I've been in the insurance business for 25 years. That's what taught me how to truly serve people. I've worked with people to solve problems in their lives, provide insurance solutions for the last 25 years. And that's exactly what you'll be doing as mayor. When you're the mayor, you're there to solve problems, to serve people, listen to their problems and solve those. And I learned that in the insurance business.
Thank you, gentlemen. Now we offer each of you 2 minutes for closing statements. And I opened up with the opening statements, moving from my right to left, so I'm going to go left to right this time. Mr. Weichenbach, you have 2 minutes to close this this event out tonight.
I want to add to my education, well, not my education. I want to come to remind you, look, people may not have had much education in schooling as these other guys, but neither did Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was a high school dropout. Remembering all the things that he accomplished. One of them in the one of them winning a war, one of them being, you take the dollar out of it, he's the one who created our dollar that we spend today. That system was created by Abraham Lincoln. So never underestimate our young people, because they're smarter than you think. But one of the things I want to take, South Haven, and regardless of how much all this growth is, it's going to end up in the same situation as H.H. Gray, where their corporate office had put all their underperforming stores on the chopping block. They're shutting down. South Haven is one of those underperforming stores. Why? And they haven't been there that long. Tanger outlet store, I'm afraid, might end up in that same boat. Where them stores opened up, middle class not gonna be there to spend their money, and they're gonna be classified as underperforming, and they're gonna shut their doors. So what's the point in having all this growth if we don't have the new money coming in? That's why I'm looking at wanting to bring a theme park. Because that brings new money in. That brings people hundreds of miles away to come back and spend their money and spend it our restaurant, our Walmart, our hotel. And it's not only healthy for South Haven, it's healthy for Dillon Grove and all the branches, Long Lake, Wall, Hernando. It's good for all of them.
Mayor Musselwhite.
I'd like to speak directly to the people of South Haven. I'd like to remind you what I said earlier tonight, that in 2013, I came to you not as a politician with no agenda, just to truly help my city. And I'm reporting to you tonight that I did what you asked me to do. And South Haven's obviously had a great past, but I believe our best days are still ahead. And if you elect me mayor again, I promise that every day my feet hit the floor, everything I do will work to make our city a better place to live. I've enjoyed working for you. It's been a blessing to my life. And I'm here to tell you, I did you right. I did South Haven right, and I would be honored to accept the job for another 4 years of getting the opportunity.
Thank you. Mr. Henley.
If elected, I would like to have an open door policy. Being inaccessible to the people who elect me is one of my priorities. I feel South Haven is socially and economically divided. I chose the hashtag
the city of Horn Lake. My intent is to be an aggressive, active manager and leader for the city of Horn Lake. We didn't get a chance to say what our educational backgrounds are, but mine is as a leader in law enforcement and in the military. My educational background also has taught me how to manage government agencies. So as mayor, I believe they're the chief executive officer of the city. It is their job to manage and lead the city in the direction they want it to go. And I have a positive vision for the city of Horn Lake. I want to repair the streets, expand the parks and the sports programs, make them more affordable for everybody in our city, because we do have low-income citizens in our city. I want to properly staff and fund the police department and other emergency services. And I will actively recruit businesses to the city. We have way too many empty lots that have been there since I started working there in 1992. While other cities appear to be trying to find places to put businesses, we just have empty lots. So I will be out there working with the state, the county, the federal government, whoever, to make the quality of life for the citizens of Horn Lake better.
Mayor Johnson.
Well, I find myself in the odd position of being the 12-year mayor. They call me the senior mayor in Hernando now, which is, or in DeSoto County, which is bizarre to me. So I think I want to remind everybody that I'm Chip. Sometimes people want to say, oh, these guys have been in office too long, let's throw them out, and they forget who they are. Well, I haven't forgotten who I am. I brought my dad with me tonight. I have my work ethic for my dad. I call him a quitter because he quit his job after 51 years at the same place. He taught me about work, and I have to answer to my family. So I think I've done my years of, and I want to call them public service because that's how I feel about it. And sometimes you have to grab a hold of yourself and say, wait a minute, I got to do this a little differently so I don't become a politician. But I think that's what I want people to remember is I'm just Chip. I'm the guy that graduated from DeSoto County Vo-Tech Metal Trades, went in the Navy, did my deal there, did what I was supposed to do, owned my own business, which was a manual labor business for 21 years. And I've been doing public service because my neighbors asked me to run for alderman one day. And while I was alderman, I decided I could maybe make a difference as mayor. And I kind of hope that my record will prove that we have done a good job, and I would like to continue doing that same job for the citizens of Hernando for the next 4 years.
Folks, that concludes the debate portion of our event tonight. Ashley has closing comments.
I just want to thank everyone so much for coming tonight. If you want to give a hand to our candidates.